Hi, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from Mr. Campbell Rocks. And obviously, today we're going to be talking about Screencastify. I need to be clear, I am not getting paid or any promotion for basically doing this tutorial. Let's do that up front. So we're going to talk about how to install and use Screencastify. We're going to talk about the difference in the free version to the paid version, and then some of the beta projects that they're working on, like students submitting videos or recordings as assignments, very similar to Flipgrid or something like that. So first of all, Screencastify is a plugin that plugs in as an extension to Google Chrome. It's always there, it's live, you can click on it, record the videos. All of those videos are saved in Google Drive in a folder labeled Screencastify. Here's my folder right here. So on this account, which is my school account, I have a paid version, which is basically the unlimited version. I can have as many videos for whatever length I want. And you can see here, I've created a lot of them over the past couple years. I actually put all of these videos in a folder and I share them with the schools that I work at. And then I use them and upload them to YouTube, which is what we're watching tonight, right? Or going through tonight. So they can also be shared, if they're in Google Drive, straight to Google Classroom. So you can run tutorials for your students and upload them straight into Google Classroom, or share those in a shared drive in Google Classroom that's always there, so you don't have to change the permissions. And that's something that Alice Keeler and all of the great people who promote Google products know, is to just have one folder that's shared with all of your classes. That way you don't have to share a file every time. Anyway, so we search up Screencastify. It's gonna ask us to add it to Chrome. Before we jump in and we add it, let's look at some of the things that we can do with Chrome. So when we go to products, you can record. Simply, you can record your browser, your entire desktop, or a webcam, and you can do any combination of those three. So you can just do your microphone, you can just do your webcam, or you can just do your desktop, or you can just do your webcam. You, in the extended version, right, the unlimited version, you can edit, which means you can merge multiple videos together, you can cut and rearrange them, you can delete clips, you can crop the clips at the end. If you had some dead space, you could overlay some audio, different things like that. The beta version of submit here is there in a testing version, which allows students to record and submit videos. So we won't spend a lot of time on that. Most of you are going to be working from a school if you're watching this. So if we go here, they have a ton of amazing courses, and they actually have a certificate. Once you get in Screencastify, you can go through all of those trainings together and get a certificate that basically says, hey, you're good to go on Screencastify. I've done a lot of that for work. Basically, if you're gonna use this for work, which for most of you, if you're watching this, is for work. Let's go to pricing. So the free version is this. You have up to 5 minutes on your videos as far as recording. This again is for an unlimited version, but wait, we're an educator. What's our discount? It's almost 40% off. These are all the features that you get along with all of these and all of these for $30. That's for an entire year. That's about $2 a month, 50 cents a week, 10 cents a day. I cannot tell you how much time and energy Screencastify has saved me. More than 10 cents a day, for real. It's all about a cost benefit analysis, right? That's 6 or 7 cups of coffee, hours and hours of time saved because the files go straight to Drive. They're automatically shareable. I can upload them straight to YouTube. You can download them as an MP4, share them other places. Just that alone, where I can record my screen, is worth that amount of money to save me time. So anyway, here are all of the free things that you can do here. You can trim, you can auto save to Drive, you can share to Google Classroom. Again, that all goes as well with here. So you can add text over clips, you can crop your recordings, you can merge videos together. I need to go through that, but let's add it to Chrome. So we're gonna click on Add to Chrome. It's gonna add that extension. You'll see here that it goes into my extensions, and I can pin or unpin extensions based on what I have here. So we're going to double click on this, and basically it's going to go to a setup for the first time. And so it's going to ask me, do I automatically want to save videos to a Google Drive? Absolutely. So we're going to send in with Google Drive. I'm already connected to just my personal Mr. Campbell Rocks account. Hopefully it doesn't ask me for my password and username because I'm going to forget. It's going to ask the same thing. It's going to access your files and folders. Are you okay with that? Yep, I am. And what this will do is it will create a folder in your drive called Screencastify, which I showed you at the beginning. It's going to ask access your camera and your microphones. If you have an external microphone, you can change that. I'll show you how to do that in a few minutes. We're going to allow that. I am an educator, and we're going to do other. And I get all of this confetti. It's amazing. So we have the overview video, how to make your first recording, Screencastify knowledge base. That's the portion that I was talking about. You can go through and go through all the tutorials that they have. I'm just doing a quick run through. Now it's going to basically walk me through this. So it's going to tell me right here what my video length is, and it's going to say, hey, do you want to upgrade? So this is, I'm going to slide over here. This is the paid version. You see it says right here, unlimited. I have access to everything. There's not a limit here. Let's go back over here just so you can see. A couple different things. So you can go to your recording straight to your drive. It's going to ask you to upgrade. You can change your options. Options will basically give you all of the things as far as privacy, optimize your mics, shortcuts on your desktop or laptop, however you want to do that. And notifications, different things like that. So to get started, I want to, and you're going to be able to see my face here in just a minute, I'm going to embed a webcam. I'm going to select my microphone, which is my default one. If I wanted to, I could do webcam only, but we're not going to. Once I click record, I'm going to get a countdown button, and a picture of myself should appear down in the bottom right-hand corner. And there's that. And it's not a picture of me because I have the wrong camera. So let me go back and change it. That's the one we want. That's an external camera that I have. We're gonna click on record. Now you're gonna be able to see me. Here I am. And you'll notice if you've been with me for a while, a lot of my earlier videos were on Screencastify and I was just doing screen shares and I had a picture of myself on the bottom right. After a while, I just realized that I'm kind of an ugly dude. You don't need to see me while I'm doing this. And I make weird faces while I do it. And so I just deleted myself off the bottom. Some people are much better looking on camera than others. And anyway, we don't need to get into that. So it's going to ask me, do I want to do an application window? Or do I want to do my entire screen? So when I click on my entire screen, it's going to give me the small version of what I'm looking at, which is basically this screen here. There's my countdown. So I am recording, and it tells me right down here, I get a notification button right down here that tells me that I am sharing. So I'm actually gonna hide that. It's very similar to Google Meet. If you're used to using Google Meet or Google Zoom, it's gonna tell you which screen you're actually showing. Down here, I have some options. I have the pen, I have the eraser. If I wanna write on my screen, I can do that. I can erase the whole thing. If I wanna change my mouse pointer, and I have that, or I can highlight here, I can do this. Again, if I had a PDF or something like that, I could actually write on the PDF or write on a web page, circle things, highlight. I'm explaining to my kids what's going on with that page or what I want them to do with that page. I can then record this video and then share it with students after the fact in Google Classroom or explain them how to do it on their own. Again, so hey, I need you to go here. I need you to watch this video, right? It's much easier with a mouse than a trackpad. If I wanted to change color, I could do that as well. So you'll notice up here as well, I have the little recording covering the Screencastify icon. So I'm actually done. I'm going to stop recording right now. It's going to ask me, this is my recording length. This is everything that's here. I'm going to stop it. If I wanted to pause, I could pause as well. And basically this is where we have our editing thing. So this is, I'm gonna skip the tour. I can clip the ends of this, but I can't actually click the, or edit the entire video. So I can clip the ends. You'll notice up here on the top right where my mouse is, it's already in Google Drive. If I wanted to get the shareable link, it's copied right there. Let's just go here, paste it here. I'm gonna open it with Video Editor. It's gonna take a minute to sync. If I were to go to my Gmail, which I'm gonna have a lot of emails in there, this could be scary. You'll see there's my folder, Screencastify, that it just created. If I double click on it, here is that untitled video that we just recorded. So connects with Drive. If I go back to my actual video, I can name it here. There's that. I can open it in editor. I can trash it if I want. I have the options here. Editor, classroom resources, different things like that. I can share straight to classroom. So when I click on share to classroom, it's gonna go to a classroom that I don't have any classes in because I don't use this account for Google Classroom, but I could just share it right there with my classes. I can publish straight to YouTube. I would have to add a YouTube channel, which I have connected to Mr. Campbell Rocks. I would want to make this public, give it a title, add a description, and I could just throw it straight up on my YouTube channel. You'll notice also if I wanted to get an embed code to put as an HTML snippet in my website or a blog or a Google Sites, I could do that as well. You would just copy this code and paste it over there. I can also download it as an MP4. I can also export the audio only if I wanted to record it as a podcast, right? Or if I wanted to read a test out loud, I could do that. I could export it as an animated GIF or GIF, depending on how you say it. There's a lot of options with Screencastify, and the greatest part about this, it's not a third-party app. You don't have to download anything. It's connected to Google Drive, and everything is connected there. So, I'm actually gonna trash this.
So I am recording, and it tells me right down here, I get a notification. Oh,
that's annoying. I'm gonna turn the volume down. Let's go down to the editor. Here's my length. I wanna trim the front. I can trim the front. If I want to trim the back, I can trim the back. And if I click on Save Trim, it's actually gonna re-trim my video. It's gonna pull that off and save that file. Once it's done, I could again download that file. I could export it as an MP4. I have all of these options, right? So I'm gonna trash this. And I'm gonna close this. Now we are going to go over to the Unlimited Edition. So again, this is me on Screencastify recording. You'll notice up here that I have the record button here. I'm actually gonna stop that. We'll only do 8 seconds. I have a lot more options when I go over to the edit part of Screencastify. Once it's uploaded, it's saved to Drive, but I wanna open this in editor. So it takes a few minutes, right, for the movie to basically get to the editing page. And this is where you have a lot more options. And so I can add text. I can select a portion of the video clip. I can drag this out. I can trim it here. If I wanted to add another piece, I could add another one. You'll notice here that I can actually shrink in on the video. I don't need to shrink in on a 9-second video. It looks a little grainy right here, but it comes out in high definition. Again, if I wanted to add text, I can choose the font. And it just puts it right on the video. Huge. I can put it anywhere I want. I can move it around. And you'll see that the text is actually here. I can adjust how long that text is on the video. So if we play the video,
we're going to stop that.
Let's go back here.
I'm actually going to stop that.
The text pops up. I have options to leave it on for this whole time. Let's get the...
Here, I'm actually gonna stop that. We'll only do 8 seconds.
So once I export this, I can export it to Google Drive or I can export it as an MP4. I'm gonna take it to Drive. We'll save that as a YouTube tutorial. It's gonna take a minute to process, right? It's gotta basically re-encode everything, the audio and the video together. So those are all in sync. If I wanted to share, it's gonna give me a shareable link or option to share with different groups, different things like that. I am not gonna do that. I can view the actual video again, and I've muted myself. There's the text right there, it's popped up. I can share it straight to Classroom. I can get a shareable link. I can go straight to YouTube. I can go get the embed code, put it on a website, anything like that. So for me, again, this is just me talking, is the free version is great. And the paid version though, for what you're paying, is fantastic. And it's quick and it's easy and it's sitting on your desktop. You can record these instantly, right? If you're in class and you could do this in between class periods or at lunch or after school to get ready for a substitute the next day and have that video sitting in Google Classroom. So when the kids walk into class the next day, they're looking at the sub and the sub's like, you guys are supposed to have the plans. Boom, it's right there in a video format. It's you talking to the kids. It's you explaining what to do. Again, if you have questions about Screencastify, there's a ton of people out there that have it, that use it. I just wanted to share this. I've seen a lot of questions about what it is and how to use it. Those are the differences between the free version and the paid version. And again, there's a short message for you after this. Now, thank you for watching this video all the way till the end. And thank you for what you do for kids on a daily basis. If this video saved you time, energy, and frustration, go ahead and like, subscribe, and share it with your teacher friends. You can subscribe by clicking up here, or you can watch another video either here or here. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.